Before we get started adding, will you show me how to make this number using base 10 blocks?
You've been talking about the Denver Nuggets playing the Utah Jazz this summer. If you want to know how many points the Nuggets scored in games 5 and 6, you would add 119 and 117, just like we're going to do today. First, I'll show you how to add three-digit numbers using base 10 blocks. You'll participate by counting with me and repeating things. Next, we'll work together and trade turns to solve problems. Then, you'll solve problems using your own blocks. Your blocks are in that bag, and we'll keep it closed until it's your turn.
We're adding 117 and 119 from our problem about the Nuggets and the Jazz. So we're going to start in the ones column. What column do we start in? That's right, the ones. We're going to combine 7 and 9. So help me count this sum. Here we go, counting together. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16. We have 16. Ooh, 16 in the ones. Can we keep that 16 here in the ones? Yeah, we can keep it here because this is the ones column. We need to regroup. We need to go next door. We're going to exchange 10 ones for a 10. Hey, count with me as I separate 10. Let's go. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. All right, so I'm going to exchange those and move those off our map, and I'm going to put that next door. In our written problem, I'm going to write a little number, another 10 over that 10 in 117, and that's called our crutch number. What's that number called? That's right, that helps me remember that I regrouped. Now,
let's solve this next one together. It's 216 plus 177. I'll put down 216 on the mat. Here's 200s, 110, and 6 ones. Your turn. You put down 100 on 177. Great, you have what, one in the hundreds place. And how many tens you put down? You put down, seven. And how many ones? Yep, seven. Hey, now let's combine those six and 7 ones. You combine those two and find the sum. Yeah! Give students clear directions before independent practice. Let students work on their own, but monitor their work. Intervene if there's an error so that they do not practice an error pattern over and over again. When there's an error, be clear about what went wrong. Model the correct approach and include the student in the process so they know how to approach the problem differently. Ask the student to complete another problem to confirm that they used your feedback. It's a good idea to put a dot or other notation next to the problem that included your assistance so that you know how many problems were completed in. So today we added numbers and regrouped using base 10 blocks. There was one time when we forgot to note our regrouping in the tens place, and we didn't write a crutch number in the problem. Now we fixed that and all the other problems were correct. We've been using base 10 blocks for a few lessons, and next, we're gonna solve problems a different way using drawings.